Here, 8 meters under the sea, we found something out of the ordinary. What looks like white liquid is actually seawater that contains small air bubbles, which in turn produce even smaller bubbles. These so-called nanobubbles are the focus of a lot of attention, as they are part of a new system that can help restore aquatic life to a healthier state. Let's see how the nanobubbles are produced in a small water tank. A jet of water is coming out from the pump on the left. Once it's plunged into the water, this small nozzle produces micron-sized bubbles that further shrink as they travel through the water, turning into nanobubbles. Using a microscope, let's take a closer look at how the bubbles shrink down to nano size. After a few minutes, the bubbles have gone from tens of microns to tens of nanometers. This is the carbon ceramic nozzle we saw earlier. The porous nature of the ceramic allows air to flow through. Apparently, it was impossible to produce nanobubbles with non-carbon-based ceramic. This system was developed not by a major company, but rather by a small factory run by Anzai Kantetsu. Their original technology has baffled many experts. There already existed several types of nanobubble systems, but all were complex and very costly. It wasn't too surprising that researchers were skeptical when they were first told that nanobubbles could be produced simply by sending air through a small ceramic nozzle. They never imagined it could be so easy. But demonstrations showed that nanobubbles remained in the water after the nozzle was taken out. The bubbles, which normally can't be seen with the naked eye, reflect light as they pass through a laser beam. Regular bubbles normally disappear quickly, but nanobubbles last for a long time, which is why they were detected by the laser. The researchers were convinced, and Anzai Kantetsu's discovery was put under the spotlight. According to developer Satoshi Anzai, their invention was the product of chance.
で、うまく野菜を乾燥させるプロジェクトがあったんですね。で、うまく野菜を乾燥させるために、あの、ちょうど水に反応する波長体のセラミックスを探してたんですよ。セラミックスで作るナノバブルはですね、バイオに非常に有効なことを発見しまして。で、バイオに有効だということは、もしかしたらですね、今まで我々がこう溜めてしまった、ヘドロといいますか、汚泥をですね、分解することができるんじゃないかという発想にたどり着きまして。
The nozzle can be easily made in a multitude of sizes and shapes. This is particularly useful for adapting the technology for large-scale applications, such as the diffusion of nanobubbles at the bottom of the sea.
他のナノバブル発生装置はですね、大型化をすることが非常に難しいんですね。大きな海域とか大きな河川で発生をするには大量の機械が必要になってしまいます。 また大きなエネルギーを必要としますので、もっと具体的に言えば高いプレッシャーであったりとか、大きな攪拌するためのモーターであったりっていうものが必要になるんですが、我々のセラミック式のものはですね、先ほど映像で見ていただいたように非常に小さな力で泡を発生することができますので、そこが大きな違いだと思います。In
2011, an experiment was conducted at a seaside park near central Yokohama. The effects of nanobubbles were tested in the seawater beneath an old dock. The device consisted of propeller-shaped stirrers and a bubble-diffusing nozzle. It was small enough to be carried by truck and can be easily moved without the need for complex heavy machinery. The device was installed in only half a day with the work of three divers. The machine was set up at the bottom, 10 meters below the surface. Although the water looked quite clean from above, the seabed was covered with about a meter thick layer of sludge. The water was murky, and there was very little sign of aquatic life.
通常では泡というのは発生したところから水面に向かって上に上がってしまうんですが、一番生物が住んでいるのは実は海の底、ボトムなんですね。そのボトムに空気を送るためには、自分の力で縮んでしまう泡ですね。 でその地震の泡が海流に乗って、ヘドロの中に染み込んでいくというような、こういった泡で、浄化するという、浄化といいますか、そういった生物たちに酸素を届けてあげるというのが非常に有効だと思います。
A series of experiments took place in the sea near an aquarium also in Yokohama in 2013. This is a 100 square meter area near the mouth of Tokyo Bay with sludge piled up 50 centimeters thick at the bottom.The nanobubble device was installed on the seabed 8 meters below the surface with a long tube to supply air from above. The system is very energy efficient, working on 2200 watt current. The white jet of bubbles coming out of the nozzle turns into smaller bubbles that, instead of going up, are dispersed around the bottom.Samples collected in February contained sandworms and small clams, two organisms commonly found in polluted waters. But in July, there were fewer shellfish, and some species of small shrimp were found in larger numbers. Arthropods like shrimp cannot survive in environments that are poor in oxygen. In half a year, the system had begun to show positive results. At the end of the experiment in January 2014,The aquatic life in the area had significantly changed. Various types of fish were observed near the reef. And seaweed had grown around the device. The sludge's thickness hadn't changed, but its content was different. Its surface had become porous like a sponge, and various organisms were found living inside. The nanobubbles had changed the ecosystem near the seabed.
東京湾といいますか、この人の多い地区ではですね、もう4月頃から10月ぐらいまでは生物が住めないような状態に陥っているのが現状ですね。我々の出すゴミと言われているものが実はその微生物の世界であり、そういったものに有効であるというのを証明できれば、我々人類も自然の中で共存して生きていける社会ができるんじゃないかと思っています。
Bubbles that shrink and remain underwater for a long time. Nanobubble technology is quite intriguing. The company's original and simple ceramic nozzle system can be adapted to a variety of situations. And there are plenty of sea regions around the world that could benefit from their invention, which can help bring back abundance and diversity to aquatic life across the globe.
This simple little piece of ceramic could end up having a big impact on our oceans. As scientists learn more about the complex dynamics of climate change, declining oxygen levels in seawater are becoming more of a concern. Nanobubbles might be one way to blow some life back into the world's largest ecosystem.